Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
Shout out to all my tea sippers out there. We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey. So make sure you guys have your teacups ready because you already know this tea is what? Piping hot. Hey, you guys, I hope you guys are doing good today. So I wanted to come on here and talk about this whole Tamar Braxton fiasco that's going on social media. So if you guys don't know, we reported a few weeks ago on Instagram that their niece, the Braxton niece, her name is Lolo Lauren Braxton. She went by Lolo, but her name was Lauren Braxton. And basically, she passed away unexpectedly. She was 24 years old. As we all know, the Braxtons, they're six deep. They have one brother who is Michael Braxton. He's 50 years old. Tony Braxton is 51. Tamar, which I was shocked by this because I thought she was in her 30s the way she acts, is 42. Tracy is 48, Tawanda's 45, and Trina's 44, okay? So they're all very close in age, very close-knit family. Michael is the only brother out of all of these girls, okay? So Lauren was his daughter. She was 24 years old. She was on the phone talking to one of her friends, and she went upstairs for a few minutes, and the friend heard her, you know, collapse. You know, she didn't come back to the phone. And I forgot who ended up discovering her, but she ended up dying in her home. And they're saying that Lauren's death was related to a heart condition, so it might have been a heart condition that she didn't know that she had. Either way, this young lady passed, and it's really sad because not even a few months ago, Trina's ex-husband, Gabe, he died unexpectedly from cancer. Nobody even knew he was sick. So this is the second death surrounding the Braxtons. Well, now the controversy is this. Her funeral was yesterday, and so Tamar Braxton goes on live, and she basically starts saying she's too tired, she's going through too much, you know, she can't go to the funeral right now, you know, she just has a lot on her mind, but she's not too tired to shout out all these projects and, you know, all these things that she's involved in. So people started dragging Tamar. People are just tired of Tamar's dismissive attitude towards everything. So I want you guys to go ahead and watch this video of Tamar saying that she's too drained to attend her own niece's funeral, okay? Who is her only brother's daughter. She's too drained to attend the funeral, but you're not too drained to perform for fans. You're not too drained to go on live. I was just so turned off watching this video. Y'all go ahead and check this out. I'm going to come back with the rest of my commentary.
Condolences. I'm just really asking for a favor.
Thank you.
So the Dungeon Tour starts tonight. And I'm in Chicago. And I am drained. Like, it's a lot.org. I'm just gonna need my Tamar friends to come out tonight and just give me energy and love and positive vibes, because it's a lot. And it's been a lot. Tune in to the Braxtons, I guess. I really don't care to watch it, because the last thing I want to see is me and my sisters arguing and Tamar's perpetuating fights again. And I'm arguing with everybody in my life. Don't feel like that, because that is not my reality. And so, I guess watch it, because I guess I'm supposed to tell everybody that. But I ain't here for all that arguing with my family, especially right now, and arguing with David, and arguing with the mailman, and arguing with pizza, because it seems like Tamar argues with everybody. I love you guys so much, but I'm in Chicago. Candy's been amazing. She's been overly accommodating, like, a real good person, and I appreciate her. So, all my Tamar friends, please come out tonight, because I have a splitting headache. You know, I don't want my sisters or my family to get upset with me, but, like, the things that's been going on, like, this is like the first time anybody in my family has passed. And let me tell y'all something. Like, If you ain't never experienced it, praise God. Get on your knees and praise him. Find you a corner, because nobody tell you about going to the damn funeral. I don't have time going to the funeral. Like, I'm still drained from that. Like, Becky, it's a lot. It's a lot. But nonetheless, everything happens, you know, in God's divine order. And you just gotta respect it and praise him anyway. You know, so come out tonight. Get your life. And watch that show, I guess.
All right, so you guys just watched that video. So, of course, people start letting Tamar have it. You know, she's saying she doesn't want her family upset with her, but there's been a lot of things going on. You know, and she's just really drained. So, of course, people started going off. One of the users says, get your ass up and go to the funeral for 2 hours, then get back to your bed. I'm not hearing this excuse. Someone else said, if you're so drained, performing should be the last thing on your mind. I would never respect or support you if you feel money and people watching you is more important than being with your family that needs your presence. And then in response to the backlash, because people was dragging her, honey, for the filth, Tamar went on to go ahead and post this. She says, PSA, please don't tell people how to heal from something you've never been through. Then she goes on to say, we are all tested differently, broken differently, our scars fade differently, we heal different. Everyone should be allowed to grieve how they want, when they want, and however long they want to. Stop giving expiry dates to pain you did not endure. If you cannot be kind, say nothing. It's okay to be quiet. Try it sometimes. You won't die. You don't have to understand everyone's journey or life choices, but it's your duty to respect it. Life visits us at the end of the day, and while you play judge, let's hope that when it's your turn, you remain standing to handle it half as strong or as perfect as you try to claim to be. Hashtag Friday inspiration, hashtag judge not, hashtag be kind. Then she goes on to say, and now you know the rest of the story. So that is what she posted, and I'm sorry, I'm not buying it, Tamar. You're full of shit, okay? You're a 42-year-old woman who is basically, to me, a spoiled brat. This is your niece, and I've always said everything doesn't belong on social media, and I stand by that. You know, if it's one thing that if she doesn't want to post, you know, condolences to her niece on social media, she doesn't need to. I know the other sisters did, Tony did. If they want to mourn publicly to social media, that's fine. I'm sure they all have their brother's number that they reached out to him and talked to him behind the scenes. So I've never been one who really goes off of, oh, well, you didn't post about this person, that means you didn't care. I don't believe that. What bothers me with this situation is she's telling folks to stay out her business, let her mourn how she wants to. Well, then why the fuck did you bring your ass to social media? If you didn't want people in your business and you didn't want the judgments, then why did you not choose to mourn how you want to mourn off of social media? So that way there'd be no judgments. That way nobody could tell you nothing. If you didn't want to go to your niece's funeral, then you didn't have to, but you also didn't have to talk about it on social media. See, Tamar likes to have her cake and eat it too. She wants to be able to use social media when it's convenient for her, but then when she gets any type of backlash by the things that she says, then all of a sudden she's the victim. And I'm not buying it. You know what I'm saying? If you can sit here and promote people to go to your show and say that you're going to sing for people and bring your A game, but then you can't take an hour out of your day, 2 hours out of your day to go and celebrate your niece's life. And one thing I can say about this woman, I don't know much about Lauren, but her brother has been on the Braxtons a handful of times, okay? I've been watching the Braxtons since day one, okay? One of my favorite reality TV shows. I've watched it from day one. I never even knew Michael had, children. I didn't know he had a daughter. So this just goes to show you that she was not a niece trying to, you know, chase her auntie's fame or trying to, you know how some people, when they have family members on television, all of a sudden they try to attach themselves to those family members because their family members are famous. Lauren just kept to herself. She did her own thing on social media. She looks just like the sister. She looks just like her aunties. But she never used that as a way to get in or, you know, beg to be on the show. She just did her own thing. So I can respect that. She was just a regular lady, you know, living her best life and doing her. Never using the Braxton's name to come up. So for Tamar to sit there and basically, you know, do all this on social media and say that you're not going to go to her funeral because you're too tired, but then in the same breath you're promoting a bunch of other stuff, to me was a slap in the face, not only to Lauren's memory, but to your brother. This is your only brother. This is his child that passed away. You know, so why even take this to social media? And then when you get backlash, now you're the victim. Now people are trying to be perfect. It's not about being perfect. You're not the only one who's ever had to deal with death, okay? You're not the only one who's ever had to deal with the funeral. You're not the only one who's ever had to deal with not wanting to, you know what I'm saying, your last memory of that person to be them laying in a casket. A lot of people have had to deal with that. But what we're saying is you don't bring it to social media. If you don't want to go to her funeral, that's one thing. Why even bring it up? Especially being that you've never even made mention of this girl before this day. You've never sent condolences publicly. You've never posted anything on your social media. So you could have just kept on talking about whatever you wanted to talk about and left Lauren's name out of it. And the sad thing is, now when you go to Google Lauren's name and go to Google stuff about her, what comes up? Everything is related back to Tamar Braxton. Tamar Braxton reveals she's too drained to attend niece's funeral. Everything now with Lauren's name is now being attached to Tamar not going to her funeral. And I think that's the saddest part of this. Because once again, Tamar has made it about Tamar. Rest in peace to that young woman. My condolences to Michael. He seems like a wonderful brother to those girls. He was there for Tamar. When Vince was going through his shit, Michael's a nurse. He dropped everything to go to the hospital, to be there by Vince's side, and to support his sister.
You know, they had to induce a coma to treat him. It's very scary.
But we are here. Your family is here.
Vince's family's here. His sister is great. His brothers are great.
To support you.
And Tracy and Trina are on the way. They'll be here.
On the way, they will be here. And look at your brother.
Mike. Look at Mikey.
Michael's here.
Did you take off work, Micah?
You came on your lunch break.
Yeah.
All the way to New York.
Mikey gonna feed you. Ew.
Well, you ain't had.
What about your hands? First of all, they ashy. And then you need a manicure and no.
It's nice having Mikey here because he's a nurse. He's able to really break things down for us to let us know exactly what's going on with Vince.
So to see her do all this on social media, being that I've been watching the show from day one, I'm not feeling this shit at all. Because anytime there's been something serious going on with any of the family members, that's when you see Michael. Michael's not on that show for that fuck shit. He's not there for none of their drama, but let something happen to that mother. Let something happen to Vince. Let something happen to the father. You will see Michael there in that in those episodes at the hospital, supporting them, hugging her, being a good brother. And this is what he gets in return? You basically minimizing his daughter's legacy? You should be ashamed of yourself, Tamar. Let me go ahead and get off this, because now I'm ranting. Y'all go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts. Deuces.